Good morning, everybody.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning. Good morning.
Onmanyo Prakhanda Dagar Aru Ajir Webinar Unustanor Kamal Bekti, Dr. Pal and Dr. Navajit Das, and my esteemed colleagues, friends from Rongia College. প্ৰথমে মই আপোনালোক সকলোকে ৰঙিয়া কলেজৰ তৰফৰ পৰা স্বাগতম জনাইছো আজিৰ এই অনুষ্ঠানলৈ। এই অনুষ্ঠানৰ এই প্ৰয়াস অতি প্ৰশংসনীয়। আজিৰ এই অনুষ্ঠানৰ বাবে মই প্ৰশান্ত ডেকা আৰু ৰঙিয়া কলেজৰ গ্ৰন্থাগাৰিক মঞ্জুশ্ৰী দেৱীক ধন্যবাদ জ্ঞাপন কৰিছো। ইয়াৰ লগতে মই সকলোবোৰ অংশগ্ৰহণকাৰী পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্টছ মই ফ্ৰেণ্ডছক মই ধন্যবাদ দিছো আজিৰ এই অনুষ্ঠানত অহাৰ কাৰণে। এই অনুষ্ঠানটো সময়ৰ আহ্বান আৰু এই কভিড-19ৰ পৰিপ্ৰেক্ষিতত আমি উচ্চ শিক্ষা ব্যৱস্থাই আমি যি অসুবিধাৰ সন্মুখীন হৈছো তাক আমি কিছু পৰিমাণে দূৰ কৰিব পাৰিম বুলি এই প্ৰয়াস কৰিছো। ৰাজ্যৰ সকলোবোৰ গ্ৰন্থাগাৰতে আমাৰ ই বুকছ ই জাৰ্নেলৰ ব্যৱস্থা আছে। যদিও আমি ইয়াক এতিয়ালৈকে সুচিন্তিতভাৱে ভালকে আমি ইমান ব্যৱহাৰ কৰিব পৰা নাই। গতিকে আজি আমি এই অনুষ্ঠানটো ৰাখিছো যে ইয়াৰ দ্বাৰাই গ্ৰন্থাগাৰীসকলৰ প্ৰচেষ্টাত সকলোবোৰ শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্ৰীয়ে এই ই বুক আৰু ই জাৰ্নেল বা ই ৰিচোৰ্চ যাৰ যি লাইব্ৰেৰীত আছে সু ব্যৱহাৰ কৰি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ মাজলৈ আগুৱাই নিব পাৰে। এই ব্যৱস্থাটোৰ দ্বাৰা আমি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলক যদি সুবিধা কৰি দিব পাৰোঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে আমি কিছু পৰিমাণে ছাকচেছফুল হ'ম। আৰু প্ৰথমে আমি সেইকাৰণে ই ব্যৱস্থাটো ই জাৰ্নেল বা ই বুকছ আমি কেনেকে এক্সপ্ল'ৰ কৰিম তাক আজি আমি এই ট্ৰেইনিংটোত আমি কৰিব খুজিছোঁ। এই ক্ষেত্ৰত মই অল আসাম লাইব্ৰেৰী এছ'চিয়েচনৰ ছেক্ৰেটাৰী ডক্টৰ প্ৰশান্ত ডেকাক মই প্ৰশংসা কৰিছো। তেখেতে যি ইনিচিয়েটিভ লৈছে ইতিমধ্যে বেলেগ বেলেগ কলেজত যথেষ্টখিনি মই কৰা দেখিছো আৰু ই সঁচাই এটা নতুন জাগৰণৰ সৃষ্টি কৰিব। আমি কিছু বছৰ আগৰ পৰাই আমি লাইব্ৰেৰীবিলাকত যিহেতু ঠাইৰ অভাৱ গতিকে আমি ই জাৰ্নেল আৰু ই বুকছৰ ব্যৱস্থা কৰিছিলো যদিও এতিয়ালৈকে এইটো ভালকে ব্যৱহাৰ হোৱা নাছিল। কিন্তু এতিয়া এই কভিড-19ৰ পৰিপ্ৰেক্ষিতত আমি বাধ্য হৈছো ইয়াক আমি এটা সুস্থ বাতাৱৰণৰ ফালে আগুৱাই নিবলৈ। যদি আমি এই প্ৰথম প্ৰচেষ্টাত সকলোবোৰ শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্ৰী এই প্ৰচেষ্টাত আমি ছাকচেছফুল হওঁ তেতিয়াহ'লে আমি পিছৰ ব্যৱস্থাত ইয়াক আমি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ মাজলৈ আগুৱাই নিব পাৰিম, ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলক ইয়াৰ দ্বাৰা উপকৃত কৰিব পাৰিম। গতিকে আমি সকলোবোৰ শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্ৰীক আজি এই অনুষ্ঠানৰ জৰিয়তে চবেই ভালকে যদি কথাটো এই জাৰ্নেলৰ কানেকশ্যনটো এইটো ভালকে বুজি পায় তেতিয়া আমি এক্সপ্ল'ৰ কৰিব পাৰিম। আশা কৰোঁ চবেই মনোযোগ দিব আৰু খুব এইটোৰ দ্বাৰা আমি চবেই লাভান্বিত হ'ব পাৰিম। এইটোৰ দ্বাৰা আমি লাভান্বিত হ'লে ইয়াৰ পিছৰ প্ৰচেষ্টাত মই প্ৰশান্ত ডেকাক ৰিকুৱেষ্ট কৰিম কেনেকে ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীলৈকে আমি এইটো আগবঢ়াই নিব পাৰোঁ। আমাৰ এই ৰিচোৰ্চ পাৰ্চন ডক্টৰ ডেকা আছে আৰু ডক্টৰ পাল আছে, তেওঁলোককো মই ৰিকুৱেষ্ট কৰিম যাতে প্ৰথম অৱস্থাত শিক্ষক শিক্ষয়িত্ৰীসকলে এইখিনি জানি লৈ পিছৰ পৰ্যায়ত আমি ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীৰ মাজলৈ এইটো কেনেকে নিব পাৰিম। সেই সময়ত ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীসকলক আমি বিভিন্ন ব্যৱস্থাৰ মাজেদি হোৱাটছআপ কল বা আমি জুমতো কৰিছো। কিছুমান আমাৰ গাঁওবিলাকত ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীবিলাকৰ নেটৰ ইমান সুবিধা নাই বা মোবাইলৰো ইমান সুবিধা নাই, তথাপিও আমি আমি ভাবোঁ আমি এই যিটো ৱেবনাৰ ইনষ্টিটিউচনৰ যিটো ব্যৱস্থা এইটো নকৰাকৈ আমি ইতিমধ্যে 30-40% আমি ষ্টুডেণ্টক আমি এই সময়ত আমি সুবিধা দিব পাৰিছোঁ। আৰু যদি আমি এইটো পাৰোঁ ভৱিষ্যতলৈ আমি এই প্ৰচেষ্টাটো আমি বেছি ফলৱতী ৰূপত আগবঢ়াই নিব পাৰিম। আৰু ইয়াৰ দ্বাৰাই আমি ঘৰৰ পৰাই কাম কৰিব পৰা যিটো ব্যৱস্থা ঘৰত থাকিয়ে সকলোৱে এই লাইব্ৰেৰীৰ যিটো সুবিধা ল'ব পৰা ব্যৱস্থা সেইটো কিছু পৰিমাণে আমি আগবাঢ়ি যাব। ঘৰৰ পৰা আমি আমিও দেখাব পাৰোঁ যে উচ্চ শিক্ষাটো আমাৰ অসমতো আমাৰ ইমান পিছপৰি থকা নাই। অসমৰ আমি জানো ভাৰতবৰ্ষক ভিতৰত আমি অসমৰ উচ্চ শিক্ষাৰ ক্ষেত্ৰত আমি কিছু পৰিমাণে আমি পিছপৰি থকা বুলি আমি ভাবোঁ। আমাৰ ছাত্ৰ ছাত্ৰীবিলাকৰ আমাৰ গাঁৱলীয়া জীৱন যাত্ৰাৰ লগত আমাৰ যোগাযোগৰ ব্যৱস্থাটো বহুতখিনি পিছপৰা। গতিকে আমি সেইবিলাকক কিছু পৰিমাণে আমি নোহোৱা কৰি এই প্ৰচেষ্টাৰ দ্বাৰাই আমি এইখিনি কিছু পৰিমাণে আগুৱাই যাব পাৰিম বুলি আমি আশা কৰিছো। শেষত মই ডক্টৰ ডেকা মই যথেষ্ট মই ধন্যবাদ দিছো এই প্ৰচেষ্টাৰ কাৰণে, আৰু ডক্টৰ নৱজ্যোতি দাস আৰু পাল পালক মই ধন্যবাদ দিছো তেখেতসকলৰ এই প্ৰচেষ্টা সঁচাই প্ৰশংসনীয়। কাৰণ এই আমি এই বন্ধটো বহুতে ঘৰত থাকি এনে বন্ধ হিচাপে পালন কৰিবৰ কাৰণে চেষ্টা কৰিছে, বা তাৰে মাজতে আমি যিবিলাকে এই বন্ধটো আমি ইউজফুল এটা ৰূপ দিবৰ কাৰণে আমি চেষ্টা কৰিছো, তাৰ কাৰণে আমি সবকে মই গোটেই পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্ট বিলাককো মই শুভেচ্ছা জনাইছো, তেওঁলোকক অভিনন্দন জ্ঞাপন কৰিছো যাতে আমাৰ এই অনুষ্ঠানটো সাকসেসফুল হয়। ধন্যবাদ।
থেংক ইউ থেংক ইউ থেংক ইউ চ' মাছ ছাৰ ফৰ ইয়াৰ মটিভেশ্যনেল ৱৰ্ডছ। ৰিয়েলি মানে আপোনাৰ কথাবিলাক সঁচাকৈ আমাৰ কাৰণে বহুত ইম্পৰ্টেণ্ট হয়। এণ্ড ৰিয়েলি ছাৰ থেংক ইউ ফ্ৰম দ্য প্লেটফৰ্ম অফ আসাম কলেজ লাইব্ৰেৰিয়ান এছ'চিয়েশ্যন। আই উড লাইক টু থেংক ইউ ভেৰি মাছ, এণ্ড আই এম অলছ' থেংকফুল টু এণ্টায়াৰ দ্য ৰংগীয়া কলেজ ফ্ৰেটাৰ্নিটি। নাও আই উড লাইক টু ইনভাইট আৱাৰ অনাৰেবল জেনেৰেল ছেক্ৰেটাৰী অফ আসাম কলেজ লাইব্ৰেৰিয়ান এছ'চিয়েশ্যন Dr. Prashant Kumar Deka sir. Before giving him to speak, just I would like to tell about him that he is the person who is working day and night for this program. And regarding the Rangia College, always he is giving some special attention, because when we start our program, we first discuss about Rangia College, and always he used to talk that we have to conduct our program at Rangia College, Rangia College. So this is possible only for our Deka sir. And Deka sir is not only working only in this area, but also he is thinking about a national level, because we are thinking to make ourselves develop not individually but our entire community. We'll develop together, we'll move together. So with this, I would like to invite Dr. Deka sir to give his speech, sir, please.
Thank you, Dr. Pal. Am I audible?
Yes.
Okay. Honorable Principal Sir, Dr. Bajendra Sakya, respected resource person of today's program, Dr. Navajit Das, librarian, and the Girls College, Assistant General Secretary of ECLA, and he's also a member of ICT Cell, Dr. Birendra Pal, Convener ICT Cell, ECLA, librarian Koliyabor College, respected faculties of Rongia College, and participants of this webinar. On behalf of ACLA, I welcome all of you this wonderful program. As our principal sir already told, that entire country is under lockdown due to epidemic COVID-19, it is noticed that all educational institutions are closed entire country. The society is at great loss in the entire area, like economy, education, lifestyle, etc. And it is our duty to keep up our education, our operation of academic society through our limited effort with limited manufacturer. During this situation, everywhere online classes, webinars, etc. are being organized to minimize our academic loss by various schools, colleges, universities, organizations, associations, etc., which are helping us to keep ourselves busy and operating during lockdown period. In view of all this, the Assam College Library Association has taken a series of initiatives for capacity building of our college library as well as the academic fraternity through its online initiative. Our main motto is to create more awareness on use of online resources and other related areas amongst the library professionals, teachers, principals, and all academic communities. We are providing this service voluntary, and it's humble contribution from us towards academic community of Assam. I would like to request all participants subscribe our SLA YouTube channel, where we have already posted different educational video for you. And it may be, I think it may be helpful for you exploring different online resources. Happy to inform you that already during this lockdown period, we have successfully completed more than 6 number of webinars in different colleges, and situation in Assam. All the technical needs and handled by the RCTCL team, by the association under guidance of Dr. Bindopal. In future also, we are planning to do more some different online program to the teachers and students of our colleges, our principal Charlotte Beaton. And it is so that all of you know that what is this, that is basic needs of our educational system. And e-resource or electronic books are documents in digital format, electronic from any part of world, electronic journal, electronic books, online database, and various format, for example, e-resource, and it can be read offline and online mode. And I offer my heartfelt thanks to our resource person, Dr. Nobhojit Das. He's a very busy person, and he's a librarian of Chahendi Girls College, and Dr. Bindopal of Koliapur College, and coordinator of RCTCL. And without his contribution, it is not possible for me to do this type of program. And both resource person will cover, I think, most important MSRT recommended some digital resource like Sotonga, Ipatsala, Shyam, Anlis, Project Gutenberg. I hope you will be benefited from today's program. At the end, I would like to offer my special gratitude to Principal Sir. He is the most dynamic person, and I know him since long time, especially thanks to IPTC conductor. And I felt this college is my own college, and I visited more institutions lots of time. This official, some official assignment. Uhurba Hinsumo Rongya College of ক্যাম্পাসত সোমোৱাৰ পিছত এখন মোৰ নিজৰ কলেজ হৈ যায়। আমাৰ ইয়াতে একলাৰ এখন আমাৰ হেৰি হৈছিল, বিএন শৰ্মা ছাৰ যেতিয়া আছিল অধিৱেশনো হৈছিল, মই সঠিক কিন্তু ক'ব নোৱাৰিম। এণ্ড আপোনালোকৰ প্ৰিন্সিপাল ছাৰ, হি ইজ এ ভেৰি ইয়ং ডাইনেমিক, এণ্ড আই ন' হিম ছিনচ লং টাইম। এণ্ড মই ভাবোঁ তেখেতৰ নতুন নতুন প্ৰচেষ্টা, নতুন নতুন প্ৰজেক্ট চব ফুলফিল হ'ব আৰু ৰঙীয়া কলেজ আগবাঢ়ি যাব। আৰু মোৰ একদম বাল্যবন্ধু মহেন্দ্ৰ কলিতাকো দেখা পাইছোঁ ফিজিক্স ডিপাৰ্টমেণ্টৰ, মই বহুত হেপি। আৰু আপোনালোকৰ গ্ৰন্থকাৰী খুব এক্টিভ হয় মঞ্জুলা, সদায় কিবা শিকাৰ কাৰণে আগ্ৰহী হৈ থাকে। মই মঞ্জুলাক আহ্বান জনাম, আজি আমি যিখিনি শিকাম সেইখিনি যেন কিবা খোকোজা যদি টিচাৰখিনিৰ মাজত থাকে, তেওঁ যেন সেইখিনি ক্লিয়াৰ কৰি দিয়ে। আৰু এটা ইন আই ৱান্ট টু এগেইন ৱেলকাম অল দ্য পাৰ্টিচিপেণ্ট টু দ্য ৱেবিনাৰ, এণ্ড আই এম চিয়'ৰ all of you will be benefited from the online e-resource program. Thank you, and goodbye.
Thank you very much, sir. Dr. Deka sir, really it's a great honor to hear you in another platform of Rangia College. Really, we are very much happy that we are working under your parental care, and definitely we will try our best to keep ACLA in a very good, comfortable positions. And thank you, Deka sir, thank you. So next, I'd like to introduce, first of all, Dr. Nobhojit Das, the member of ICTCL of Assam College Librarians Association, and he is the librarian of Handy Girls College, Guwahati. Sir is very dynamic, and he is also my teacher also. I should acknowledge it. He has also taught me during my master's classes. So really, it's a great honor to be a part with, along with my teacher, Dr. Nobhojit Das, sir. Sir, please kindly give your lecture on e-resources, and you will be talking about NLIST, you will be talking about National Digital Library. So I would like to invite Dr. Nobhojit Das, sir. Please, sir. Nobhojit Das, sir, I am audible.
Yes, am I audible?
Yes.
Let me share my screen. Post disable. Please enable to share my screen. Good morning to all of you. And I would like to congratulate all of you because we have gathered virtually here for a noble cause. So I welcome you all. At the very outset, let me share my screen. Birender, it is not enabled. Message is coming, host disabled participant screen sharing.
Is it? Just a second. But we have not disabled, so it's already there.
But I am trying, but message is coming, host disabled, participant screen share sharing.
Dr. Das.
Yes, sir.
I think you should carry on. Only one person may be not hearing your lecture. I am hearing.
Sir, you continue. I am Navajit, sir. Just you continue. I am just giving the access.
Because I have to show in my program, I have to show live demonstration how to access different resources from different sites. Actually, today I am going to explain show you how to access resources from NLIST site as well as from NDLI site. Already we know that in this situation it is not possible to take classes or provide information service physically. So at this situation everything is going on virtually. So in remote teaching learning method, we have to adopt some platforms as well as we have to take some e-resources for our learning materials. So we know that there are four pillars of higher education. Number one is curriculum. Number two is instruction. Number three is assessment. And number four is the research. These four are the pillar of higher education. And in this situation, number one, already we have a set curriculum. In the instruction part, as we have to provide instruction, impart instruction in remote mode. So for this, we need a platform for taking classes, as well as we need some resources which are available in digital form. So our main emphasis is how we can help to provide you digital resources. So when we are calling tell about the digital resources, then there are two type of digital resources here, subscribe digital resources and free digital resources. So our emphasis is basically on, at this situation, it is not possible to subscribe digital resources at a phrase. So whatever we have and whatever digital resources we can access freely, that we have to access properly. We have to know the method so that we can access in a best way for our use. So my plan is to show you today the NLIST. NLIST is a subscribed resources, but most of the college has subscription to the NLIST because this is a very low cost but very high valued resources are available. Since the government organization is providing these facilities to us at a very minimum cost, we are getting it, NLIST. The NLIST is providing to you from InfliBNet, and I'm going to show you the NDL also. If I could share, still it is not visible.
Okay, sir. So, I'm sharing from my side. Just you go continue. Just you tell, I will share from here. There might be some problem from your end. We have given the access. Navajit, sir.
Yes.
I'm sharing the screen. Just see, you tell the presentation. I'm just sharing from my side. Shall I go to National Digital Library? First?
No. Okay. I should go actually. Okay. So first I will show you the national resources of National Digital Library. So For National Digital Library, first of all, we have to go to the site of National Digital Library. The URL of National Digital Library is https://ndl.iitkgp.ac.in. So this is the URL of NDL. So when we enter, so this is the dashboard of NDLI. This is a Ministry of Human Resource Development project, NDLI. Virender,
yes,
you have got the home page?
Yes, yes. So you just see on the screen and you tell.
So in this dashboard, there are two options. You can access the resources by logging to the site. In the rightmost corner, top most corner, you will see login option is there, or without login. But my suggestion is that you should log in to the site, because when you go inside, some resources are there which need login. Without login, you cannot access those resources. Some resources are there, not all. Now I'll show the some of example. These are the options. You have seen the buttons. So suppose I need a document. I means a students need a document or a teacher need a document. Suppose I want to learn the electronic structure and covalent bonding. I need some materials, learning materials of electronic structure and covalent bonding. So for this, I have to go to the science. This is the button for science courses. So here, I have clicked, then I have got the list of the subject. So since I need electronic structure and covalent bonding, this is a topic of or subject of chemistry. So I should go with chemistry. Here I will click. Then you will see under chemistry, these are the topics. And here you should know there are different type of documents available in this NDLI. So some are video lectures, some are web courses, some are questions and solutions. So all these are essential for you. So if you need text material, then you should go with the web course. In the very first one, web course. Or if you learn through some video lectures, you can go with the video lecture. So I will first show how you can access the web course or text material. Suppose this is a matter of what I want to know, electronic structure and covalent bonding. This is a matter of chemistry. So I'll go here, the very first one. So when you access electronic resources, then in every cases, you will get two panel, right panel and left panel. So if you here see the right panel, I have entered to the chemistry and biochemistry. These are the subtopic of chemistry and biochemistry. Here, if you see this plus sign means it has again sub branches. So my topic will be under basic organic chemistry here. So I will click here. Then I will get this web course. So I will click here again, some sub branches are here in web course. Then I'll get this. So here the very first one is my required topic, electronic structure and covalent bonding. So I'll click here. This is my needed material. So when I click, I have got here structure and bonding one, structure and bonding two. That means there are two lectures for this particular topic. So if I suppose I would like to go with this lecture one, structure and bonding one, then I'll click here. And when I click in the right left panel, you will see here is a prompt, open content in new tab. So if I click here, open content in new tab, then you will get the material. Now you see here, this program is offered by NPTEL, and this is program is designed by a faculty member of Department of Chemistry, IIT Guwahati. So now I need the course. So for getting the course, you have to tap here, start course. So if I click here, start course, then I will get the resources here. You see, there are 7 pages of these resources, page 1, page 2, page 3, like that, 7. So my humble suggestion to you that you should go with all the pages, and at the last, for student, you see, at the last, you will get some questions. You should try to solve this question also to test yourself whether you have learned or not. And in the last, you will get some references also for further study. These are the 3 books from which you can learn more on this topic. So this is how you can find out your required topic, your required material from NDLI. Now, I just would like to show you question and solution. Mirendor, So the chemistry question and solution, second topic, stems EZ or pora. Second, chemistry, biochemistry, second two.
Under science.
Under science, yes. Chemistry, biochemistry.
Chemistry, biochemistry.
Second
then,
topic.
Yes, then.
Chemistry, question and solution.
Okay, then.
So click here.
Okay.
So here you will get question and answer. In very simple way, you will get question and answer. Here, if you see chemistry in the right panel, you will see the topics. So on what topic you need, accordingly, you will get question answer. Suppose I need some question on quantum chemistry. So if I click here, as it is plus signs are here, so there are some subtopic, you see. These are the problem in the right panel. You see right panel, quantum chemistry, these are the problem. Problem under problem 18, these are the some serial number 0646, 0647, like that. So if you need, suppose this is the question, you need this question answer. So you click here. Then in the left panel, you will get the question as well as the solution. Is it visible, Birendra?
Yes, yes.
Question and answer?
Yes.
Okay. So this is the question and this is the solution. If you want to go to the next, then you can click here in the next. Or if you do not want to see one by one, then you can go to your right panel, you choose your question, and accordingly you click and you will get your question and answer. So this is very help. This would be very helpful for students as well as teacher, because teacher also need some question and answer so that they can pass it to the students for solution. So this is how you can access learning materials from NDLI. So if you try, then it would be very easy for you, but you have to try. Then only you will understand it better. In other subject also you can go. If you want to go for other humanities subject under humanities, then you have to click humanities, then you will get subject of humanities. Birendra, come to the dashboard.
Yes, I am on the dashboard, sir.
Okay. Or if you need some research material, then you can go for this scholarly publications here. In the left side, second row dashboard, second row, blue tab, it is here, scholarly publications. So according to your need, you can go and you can find out your materials in NDLI. Perhaps this is sufficient for you. So if so, then I will go for another topic, that is ENLIST. So again, I have come to my browser. I have opened my browser. Then I need, suppose now I would like to show you ENLIST resources. So almost all the colleges have subscription to the ENLIST resources, as already I have mentioned you. So for accessing ENLIST resources, first of all, your college have to subscribe. The subscription rate is very low, only 5,000. Inclusive of all taxes, you need 5,900 for 1 year only. And it is for your information that the ENLIST is providing us more than 6,000 journals and more than 31 lakh ebook. And the URL of ENLIST is www.inflibnet.ac.in. So for accessing ENLIST, one most important thing is that you should have one member ID and password. Without having member ID and password, you cannot access this ENLIST resources. And if you don't have your member ID and password, then you should contact your librarian. If you don't have member ID and password, you should contact your librarian, and librarian can provide you your member ID and password instantly. So with member ID and password, you have to log in to the ENLIST services. For login, I have come to the homepage of InfliBnet. Then you go to the major activities here. Then you will get in the number third, you get ENLIST program. Click here. Then you will get the ENLIST dashboard here. So for a member, you have to log in. Then this is the right, in the right corner, you will get, this is in the right tab, this is member login in orange color. So go to login. Then you will ask to put your username, enter username. Username is your registered email ID. So you have to type here your email ID and then enter your password. So you can, if you have password, it is okay. If you don't have your password, please obtain it from your librarian. So I am going to enter my password. Then log in. So here you will see the resources. If you a little scroll down, then you will see the resources. There are two parts. All resources are shown in orange color. You see e-journal, full text, e-books, full text. All are here. So you see the numbers, how many journals are available in this service. Suppose American Institute of Physics, 18 journals, Annual Review 33, Economic and Political Weekly, okay, Indian Journal 180, JSTOR, you see 2,500 journals. In the right side, you see in ebook, Cambridge Book Online 1,800 books, Ibrary 1,50,000 books. So, first I would like to show you the ebook, how you can access ebook. So, if you want to access ebook, go to the any one of it. So say I will access ebook from Ibrary. So here I have to click here Ibrary. So when I click library, I have entered to the library. Here, there is an option SARS. So there are three options. You can go with simple SARS in this box, SARS box. You can go with advanced SARS, or you can browse by subject. This is the option browse by subject, advanced SARS. If you have a specific SARS, you know the title, you know the author name, or you want book, a particular book published by a particular publisher, then you can go with the advanced SARS. Now, for example, I am going to search a book in simple search. Suppose nowadays at this and pandemic situation, one important technology is required, that is PCR. So I'll go with this term. Suppose I need books on PCR, then SARS. So when I search books on PCR, these are the list of books. How many books you see in the top? 6971. Now, this is a huge number of books. If you want to reduce it or make it specific, then you can refine your SARS from your left panel. If you see in the refine your SARS, then you can refine your SARS by different options. Here it is given. Suppose year of published. Suppose you need current 4 years document. Then you go, you click here 2020, only one book. Then 2019, then total it becomes 6, then 2018, then again it is a little bit increased, 155 book. And if you want more than so more, then if you click so more, then other years will be displayed here. Then you go with, suppose I need 4 years, 17. Okay, this much I need. So then I will reduce so less the errors because it's a very long list. So 4 years, it is shown 438 books. Again, one important for refine, you should go with language because we have understood English language. The German, French language, most of we do not understand. So English. So it will show only 395 books. So accordingly, you can go refining and refining. By subject also, you can refine. So here you see, I'd like to show you. Suppose I need a particular book. So as I have searched a books on PCR, suppose this book is important for me. Say, the stem cell microenvironment and its role in regenerative medicine and cancer pathogenesis. Virendra, have you got this in green color book?
I did not get, sir. Sir, first option you take it, molecular tools.
Molecular tools, okay. Okay, okay, the very first book. Very first book. Molecular tools. So here, if you see in the right side, there are four options. If you bring your cursor in the first option, it will show full download. In the second option, read online. In the third option, show the table of contents. And the fourth option, it is very important option, save to bookshelf. Now, one by one, I'll tell you. So full download, though it has provided the full download option, my suggestion is you should not go with full download because though it is showing full download, when you will download, then some chapters may be omitted in your download file because all the book may not be permitted to download at a time. So similarly, you should not go with read online directly. Better way is you should go with the table of content because without going the table of content, we cannot decide whether the book is essential for me or not. So that is why you should open the table of content first. So I will click table of content. Then the table of content will be displayed here, you see. This is the table of content. So here you will get all the books part. So everything, including preface, introduction, acknowledgement, everything. So from here, you saw the chapter one. Chapter one, chapter two, chapter three, like that you will get. So you go with the chapter one and you have got the download option here. So chapter by chapter, if you want to download, then you should go with chapter by chapter, download PDF. Or if you want to read, read online. So this is the best practice. Without going the full download, you should go with chapter to chapter. And if a particular chapter has subsection, then you can see by going with show subsection. Suppose if this chapter has subsection, then it will show the subsection also. Yes, this chapter has subsection. You see, this has subsection 3.1, 3.2, 3.3, 3.4, like that. So you can go with subsection also, and you can download a particular subsection. Because for one book, whole book may not be required for you. A part, a chapter, two chapter, three chapter, like that, it may be required for you. So you should not download the full book. You should go with one by one. Even if you need the whole book, then to chapter by chapter, you download it. Birendra, go back to the options again. Next, I want to show you the most important and most valuable options here. In the rightmost, save to bookshelf. Have you seen the save to bookshelf? So this is a very great facilities given to us. So what happened? Suppose today I have searched this book. So I have spent some time. So out of these 395 books, I have to select my required book. Suppose I have selected three books. So again, tomorrow or after 7 days, if I need this book, again, I have to search. But here is the option. This is the save to bookshelf is the option. And the next time you need not to search this book, your required book again and again for a particular topic, if you search it once. Then suppose this book I need, so I want to keep this book in my bookshelf. So how to do it? So you go with this button, click here. Then it will prompt you, one pop-up menu will come, add to bookshelf. Here you are asked in which folder you want to keep your book. Then you come here in the drop down in the box in the right side. You click here. Here there is an option new. So in new, you click here and name yourself. Self name. Suppose this book belongs to microbiology. So I'll name myself as a microbiologist. Say microbiology. 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 I have given the name microbiology. So then you click here the blue button, add items. So now your pop-up menu has gone. Now you may be surprised, where is my book? Where you will get it? So in the next day or in the same day, if you need the book, you just enter to the library, that is here, library. Then you come to this blue bar. Here you see blue bar in there and different four tabs here, SARS bookshelf. You go to the bookshelf, click here in the bookshelf, then you will ask which bookshelf you need. In the left side, the name of the bookshelves are there. So in the left side, if you have to click the name of yourself, say microbiology. So your self name is microbiology. So click here the self name. Then it will show that yes, you have stored this particular book in this self. So it will show how many books you have kept in this particular self. All book will be shown here in this. So this is how you can keep your required book in your own bookshelf. You need not to search book again and again in the site. So here are the option, what you want to do, now you can do. So you can open the content page and accordingly you can download in future one by one when you get time. Am I clear? Birendra?
Yes, sir.
I would like to show very quickly the journals also.
Yes, I'm coming
will
to the journal.
Will time permit me? Will time permit
time,
me?
Time is already crossed, sir, actually.
Let's show the journals very quickly. Okay. JSTOR. So I will come to the journal, e-journal, how you can get these e-journals. Suppose I want to go to the JSTOR. So here is the option of searching or browse. You can browse by subject, you can browse by type, or you can go for the search. Suppose here I want to search again the same topic, suppose real-time PCR. I need book or journal articles from real-time PCR. So you search here real-time PCR. When you will search, so here the list of the journals you have got. These are the journal articles you have got. So here again, there are, if you need this article, suppose very fast article, real-time PCR as a tool to study weed biology. So suppose you need this article, then what you do here, you can download directly. So you can download directly. So same procedure here, there is a no problem as in the ebook we have got. You can download directly the articles, or you can save it. This is again, suppose you have selected three journals articles, but you have no time to read all this today itself. So you can save it. So how you can save? Here, you click here, save. Then you will be prompted. Here one pop-up menu will come. So here it is telling that your article is saved in your workspace. So if you want to see, then you can see the workspace, or in future, suppose next tomorrow you will come and you want to see your articles, but you need not to search here. So what you can do, you just enter to the JSTOR and go to this tool. In the top you see advanced search, browse, and then tool. If you click, bring your cursor in the tool, you will get workspace. If you click in the workspace, it will show you whatever articles you have saved in your workspace. Birendra, is it visible workspace?
Yes, sir, it is visible.
Okay, so show them these articles in the workspace. So this article we have saved. So it is there in the workspace. So now you can read, but keep in your mind, when you keep a particular journal article in the workspace, then it is a very temporary space. It will exist only for 2 days. So whatever you want to do, if you want to download or if you want to read or whatever you want to do, you should do within 2 days. It is very temporary one. not like bookshelf. Bookshelf is a permanent one, but workspace is for 2 days. After 2 days, it will expire. So I think this is sufficient for you. So if you have any problem, you can ask me in your chat box. If you have any question, then I'll try to answer. One most important, yes, one left is there, that is cite this item. So if you are writing any academic writings, then it is very important to cite. Citation is essential. Put references is essential. So for citation and referencing, so you need to prepare references and citation. So for this, here is the option. You need not to write anything. So you go to the cite this item. You click here. So here you will get this citation according to three standard. So for citation and referencing, we know we have to follow some standard. Standard may be MLA, standard may be APA, standard may be Chicago, and there are some other standard also here. Three standard is given. Suppose you are following Chicago standard. So you just copy this Chicago standard and you just open one WordPress and paste it. You will get the references directly if you want to cite this particular article. So this is the method. Or if you are following any tools, reference management tools, you can directly copy or send these articles to your reference management tool by exporting your data. This is export citation facility is there. So you can do it. So at this, I would like to conclude. And it is a great privilege for me to address you. So whatever I know, I have tried to show you. So if you have any question, you can ask. And thank you very much for patience hearing and given me this opportunity to speak something before you. Special thanks to the principal sir of Rongia College, as well as all of you, and special thanks to, I must thanks our general secretary, as well as our Birendra Pal. Thank you
Dr. Navajit Das sir. Really, it's a very wonderful presentation indeed, and really we have seen many new things, many new innovations, many new informations in the analyst, which may help our learners, which may help our academicians to develop more. So sir, I behalf of on ACL, I would like to thank you for your wonderful presentation. Now just I would like to invite our honorable general secretary of Assam College Library and Association, Dr. Deka, to take 1 minute. He want to give something about his views. Dr. Deka sir.
Okay. Actually, thank you, Dr. Navajit Das, for your nice presentation. Actually, this facility is available in our door, actually. This facility is available in our computer, in our blog, everywhere. So actually we are not aware this facility. Manjushri.
Yes. Dekha sir.
Okay. Yes. Okay. 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 Okay
Always, we are very much thankful to you. Now, the next part of presentation will be, we'll be discussing about some of the e-learning platforms. Like, we'll be discussing about Swayam, we will be discussing about Swayamprabha, we will be discussing about EPG Pathshala, we will be discussing about EPG Pathshala, then Sodganga, and then lastly, we'll be talking about the open access e-resources, how to get the open access e-resources. There are n number of platforms we can use it for our academic purposes. Just as I will start sharing my screen. And I will directly go to the Google page and I will type Swayam. See, this is the official website of Swayam, swayam.government.in. And Swayam Central, it is an e-learning portal of MHRD. And why the Swayam is important? Because everywhere we are now hearing this term Swayam. Now what actually Swayam means? Everyone might be aware about the Swayam. See, the basic importance of Swayam is that from class 9 till postgraduate level, learners can not only learn, but also there is a provision of certification system. That means if you are engaged from class 9 to till postgraduate, our students can definitely do some of the courses in Swayams. The course hosted on Swayams are in 4 quadrants, that is video lecture. You'll get specially prepared reading materials. Then self-assessment, you can also assess yourself by tests and quizzes. And then an online discussing forum for clearing your doubts. Sometimes you might have some doubts, then you can directly contact with the experts. And see, the basic importance of Swayam is that, see, all the national bodies of India like AICT, NPTEL, UGC, CEC, NCERT, NEOS, IGNU, IIMBM, NITER, all these bodies working on different fields, like AICT is working on the engineering and technical backgrounds. Similarly, NPTEL is for engineering, UGC is for postgraduate level. Similarly, CEC for undergraduate level. All these bodies are making different courses for their particular areas, and then it is delivered through the Swayam platform. And respected participant, the basic importance of Swayam is that it need not have to bother about the equivalency of certificate, because see, government has already given this guideline, credit transfer. This guideline is already given by MHRD guideline for developing courses. If you are a faculty member, how you will develop your Swayam courses? This guideline is also available. If you are interested, you can develop your own courses in Swayam. Even university grant commissions credit framework for online learning courses, they have given this guideline. Even AICT has also approved this guideline. So nothing worry about how to take courses from Mumbai University or Delhi University, provided your university should accept first, then only you can do these courses. And it's very easy. The thing I will show you, that all courses, this is all courses means the entire courses available in Swayam, you will find within a single option now. So see, these are the upcoming courses. That means you can enroll for these courses. If you are interested, suppose this is the courses on plant groups. And this is a 12 weeks courses starting by 31/5/2020. Similarly, there are different n number of courses you can go and you can enroll for this. There are also ongoing courses. Ongoing courses means you cannot enroll for the ongoing courses, but you can learn the educational materials available in the enrolled courses. That means there are different videos, different learning materials, you can use it, but you cannot now enroll for these courses because enrollment is closed now, but you can learn for your academic purposes. So this was all about all upcoming courses. Now, respected participants, one important thing I want to show you. Earlier, there was an option here called ARPIT. ARPIT is why important for the teachers, annual refresher program in teaching. That means suppose we are doing some refresher courses earlier, we have to go for 14 or 21 days and we have to stay here. Now this is possible through SWAYAM platform. You can do this ARPIT courses under SWAYAM platform, and the certificate is quite equivalent to your regular certificates. Even Government of Assam, DPI, Director of Higher Education has approved this. So nothing to worry about the ARPIT courses. And since SWAYAM is not only available in English language, but it is also available in the regional languages of India, like Hindi, Tamil, then Gujarati, Bengali, Kannada. So in this way, these are available. You can enjoy the different educational materials available under the SWAYAM platform. And see, the basic importance of this SWAYAM, I will show you. During this COVID situation, they have categorized their services very specially. Now, if you go and visit this, see, here you will find this entire platform of resources. Like if you are from non-engineering courses, you will get the information here. If you are from engineering background, then you have to go to this option. If you are from the school or from the high secondary level, then you can go for the NCERT textbooks. It is very important for the school education, school teachers. Then secondary and senior secondary courses like NEOS, it is also available from here. So basically all the things are available now. It's our responsibility that we can go one by one. So I will show you the non-engineering courses. Since we are basically from the non-engineering background now, and I will show you. So see, there are options called PG and UG. Now, if you are from PG background, then you go to this option and you choose your courses from here. That means here you, it is only for the learning purpose, not for the certification. Here you can only learn. And this is UG courses. Suppose I will show you one example in the UG courses. If you are from the political science, human rights in India, there are 42 courses and you just select any one of it. Once you select, then see, you will find e-text. E-text means the entire information available on this topic is prepared by expert and it is for your understanding. And this is the self-learning. Self-learning means you will enjoy the videos available in the topic. That topic, what I was talking, there is some error. I will take another video. Suppose I will take a topic on artificial intelligence, suppose. And then I will select a module and then I will play it. So my intention is not to play entire video, just I want to make you aware, and maximum of you are already aware about this. So this was all about SWAYAM. Now the thing I want to show you is that registration in SWAYAM, this is very important. Now see, you will see this option sign in. Sign in means you can do your registration from here. You can do your registration through three process. You can directly register with your Google account, with your existing Facebook account, and also your Microsoft account. These three, you can register in the SWAYAM courses. Registration does not mean that you are enrolled for a courses. Registration means that you are registered for the SWAYAM platform. Now, under the SWAYAM platform, you just go to this option called upcoming courses or ongoing courses, and then you enroll yourself. First of all, you have to sign in, and then you have to go to this all courses, and then you have to enroll for that particular courses. Then only your enrollment will be successful. Just registration is only for the registration in the SWAYAM platform, and enrollment is for that particular course. So this is all about SWAYAM. And if you want to download the mobile application of SWAYAM, then this is also available in your smartphones. You can download from here also, from Google Play, and you can use it according to your purpose. So respected participants, I hope that I have tried my best to make you aware about SWAYAM. SWAYAM is a platform of e-learning where not only you can learn, but also you will get certificates, which is equally approved as per the regulations. Now I will move to the next topic. This is called SWAYAM Prabha. Now you might be aware about this SWAYAM Prabha, because every day we are hearing these words, because UGC, MHRD are giving always these guidelines to use these MHRD facilities. Now, actually, what does Swayamprabha means? The name Swayam and Swayamprabha, it seems like similar, but there is a difference between Swayam and Swayamprabha. Swayam was a platform of e-learning with certification, but Swayamprabha is a group of 32 DTH channels. That means it is related directly with your television set. If you have DD disc, if you have DISH TV at your home, then you can enjoy the different educational materials available in the Swayamprabha platform. And see, there are channels allocations. Channels allocations means there are 32 DTH channels. Each channel has been given assigned to the each field. Like humanities, for one channel has been assigned. Similarly for Sanskrit, similarly for different social science. In this way, if you go one by one, then you will get 32 DTH channels. And then, see, once you go to this particular thing, then you will understand the entire course which are available on the platform. And this is the archive videos. Archive videos means the program which is already telecasted. If you see, this is the current program. Current programs means these programs are now being live telecasted in the television sets. See, 21/5 Thursday, and see these programs are, if you want to see, see this program is repeated 5 times in a day. Same program. If you somehow you miss the program for one time, then you may enjoy the same program in the same day in another time. 5 times it is repeated. And this is the live programs details. Similarly, these are the upcoming programs which are going to be conducted in the Swayamprabha, and these are the archive. Archive means the programs which are already telecasted, and these videos which have been telecasted in the television, you can also enjoy from here directly. So this was all about Swayamprabha. For Swayamprabha, it is better to go to your television set and you enjoy the different educational videos by sitting at your home. Right now, this facility is not available in Tata Sky, and Tata Sky and Airtel, this facility is not available, but in DISH TV and DD Disc and different government channels, this is available. See, this is what is Swayamprabha. There is an option called frequently asked questions. So you will find most of the informations, and whether Swayam and Swayamprabha is same, they have written no. So why it is different from Swayamprabha? Swayamprabha is a name given to 32 DTH channels, and Swayam provides online MOOC courses with certificate credit transfer. So there is a difference. Whatever I have told you, this is the thing you can understand. So you just go to this frequently asked questions, and most of the answers are already been predefined here. And there is a process here called registration. Now, what is the benefit of this registration? You will get the email alert. You will get SMS alert. Suppose what are the upcoming programs coming of your interest, then you will get this information from this registration process. So I will note, so the registration is very easy. Just it will take 30 seconds. And there is a application of Swayamprabha. If you want to download the application of Swayamprabha, you go to the Play Store and you download the Swayamprabha application. You can download in your mobile phone now. And this Swayamprabha portal is maintained by InfliNet Center. InfliNet Center maintains this portal, and they give the informations regarding the different educational channels, what are the programs are being going to be telecasted, and what are the programs already been telecasted in the television. This information you will get from this Swayamprabha portal. Swayamprabha is a, this is a portal, and what I am talking about the DTH channel, 32 DTH channels, if you go and you can enjoy these channels under your television set. Now I will move to the next topic called Shodh Ganga. Now Shodh Ganga is very much familiar with this portal. Most of the academicians know about this Shodh Ganga. And now it is compulsory that we have to upload our thesis in Shodh Ganga portal. This website is not working today. But then also, just I want to highlight that your PhD thesis or anyone PhD thesis, if you want to browse, if you want to download, then you can see from the Shodh Ganga websites. All the universities of India have joined this Shodh Ganga, and you just go and you will find most of the universities' theses are available in the Shodh Ganga platform. Then I will be talking about EPG Pathshala. See, this is another e-learning portal of MHRD under the NME ICT project. And also you will get lots of educational materials available here. You will get lots of e-adhayan, e-books is also available, online courses is available. So you just go and explore. I will show only one for an example. Students corner, you just go to the students corner. And suppose if you are a student of sociology, then you go to this option sociology, you will get 526 educational materials. Just you click any one of it, and then you just select your module, and then you select your submodule, and then it will give you the learning materials. This is the e-text prepared by the expert on that particular topic, classical sociological theory. You can download it. Then it is a self-learning. Self-learning means the video. You can play it.
Of modern European sociology, the sociology of Ibn Khaldun. This module comes under the paper Classical Sociological Theory. In this module, we're going to discuss.
So I will stop here now. And now I hope this is the Sodh Ganga mirror thesis. You see, you can find earlier it was not open, now it is open. See, all these universities like Acharya Nagarpur University, Ahmedabad University. If you talk about Assam, then you will be talking about Assam Downtown University. They have uploaded their thesis. Assam University, 1018 thesis is uploaded. Similarly, if you go to Guwahati University, then in the Guwahati University, Dibrugarh University, 196 thesis they have uploaded. Similarly, if you talk about Guwahati University, then they have also uploaded maximum number of theses. So just you go to this option and you will get the theses of the entire universities available in India, and you can access according to your requirement. This is just point of view of I'm talking about learning. Now there are other facilities also in Sodh Ganga. I'll be not going to the detail like anti-plagiarism and all. That is another topic. You can check your thesis, you can check your papers, how to check your papers. That is another domain. Just my intention is only to make you aware about Sodh Ganga. Then I will come to the next topic called open access e-resources. Now, respected participants, I know that you might be aware about this word open access e-resources. Now, open access e-resources are free e-resources. Just from the layman point of view, I'm giving a definition. Open access e-resources are the free resources available in the internet platform. You need not need any money to access these resources. Although the resources are free, but it does not mean that it is of low value. Value of the resources are same because the content is having same importance as that of the commercial resources. I will show you some of the websites like DOAJ. This is called Directory of Open Access Journal. Directory of Open Access Journals means the entire open access journals available in the world, you will find here in this directory. To understand more about this directory, just I want to cite an example. In India, if there are 350 or 400 universities, then it is not possible for a scholar to visit each and every university's website. So what the scholar will do, he will go to the UGC website and he will visit from that UGC website, and entire universities will be, then he will be given the access. So similarly, the Directory of Open Access is also doing the same work. They are giving the access of all the open access journals available in the world. You can go and you can use this according to your requirement. Like you can browse by subjects, like if you are from agriculture, if you are from library science, if you are from education. So in this way, you can go and you can access your requirement. It's very simple. Just it is one step, you just forward and it will get. Then you just go to DOAB. It's now DOAB. This is called Directory of Open Access Books. Directory of Open Access Books also works on the same philosophy of DOAJ. It also gives access to all the e-books available in the open access platforms. Within a single platforms, you will get access to these resources available in the open domain of internet. Now I will show you another e-books platform called Project Gutenberg. And in this Project Gutenberg, you will get lots of ebooks. You can download these ebooks according to your requirement. So just you visit all these websites, practically you will be benefited more. Then another website, I want to show you Internet Archive. And here also you will get lots of ebooks for your purpose. So this is all about the e-resources platforms, and beyond this, there are lots of e-resource platforms which may be available in the internet, and it's now our interest how much we can access those resources, because these resources is not that it is available from today. These resources are available since during 5 to 10 years it is already available. Even the analyst facility, what Dr. Novajit sir has told, it's a very important platform. We can use it for at least in our colleges, and then also the National Digital Library of India, they are giving a very huge resources, and during this COVID situation they are giving especially these resources to us. So I request all the participants to kindly go through these websites, and definitely it will help you more. So with this, I'd like to conclude my presentation, and I would like to also request all the participants, kindly, if you have any questions, then please raise your hand in the Zoom application. There is a facility in Zoom to raise your hand. You just raise your hand. Also, you can put your questions in the chat box. You just type your questions in the chat box. We will try to pick up and we'll try to give the answers. Thank you, ma'am. Dipali madam, you're raising your hand. Just, I want to go to you. Madam, please unmute yourself. Dipali madam, please unmute yourself from your end. Dipali madam, please unmute yourself. Okay, we cannot connect with Dipali madam. Any other participants, if any question, then please ask your question. Please raise your hand in the Zoom applications. I request all the participants, please kindly put your questions in the chat box in the Zoom applications. Or also you can raise your hand in the Zoom applications, because your questions means a lot to us, and definitely this will be an interaction, not in the form of questions. We are also from the same background, you are also from the same background, and we'll just share our experience. I haven't seen any raising hand. Okay, still then also I would like to go to directly to Apurva Kumar sir. I have been observing you, Apurva Kumar sir. If you can hear me, Apurva Kumar sir. I am also observing Bimal Das sir. Sir, please unmute. Yes, Bimal Das sir. Sir, are you hearing me, Bimal Das sir? Okay. So I would like to move to Rujab Musahari sir. I have been observing his smiling face. Sir, please, if you have any expectations or if you have any comment, please kindly share with us.
Sir, I have no questions, sir.
Okay.
I am listening first.
Thank you. Then I am also observing Dr. Guddu Prasad. Sir, please kindly give one or two views. Please unmute yourself first, please, sir, from your side.
Hello. Dr.
Yes,
can you hear me?
Yes, you are audible, sir.
Just I want to know about MOOC, MOOCK.
Yes, MOOCs.
Yes.
Okay, sir. Yes, really, it's a very interesting question you asked, actually. And I was expecting this question also. MOOCs, Massive Open Online Courses. And Massive Open Online Courses is nowadays, it is very famous. It is not only a now requirement. It is our, now see, whatever the resources I have shown here, we are accessing from others now. Now, what about our own courses? What about our own regional courses? Like if you are from, want to conduct your courses in Bodo languages, if you want to conduct your courses in Assamese language, then what we have to do? So for that, we have to make content. You have to make a group in your college. You have to make a group in a academic fraternity, and you can develop certain MOOC courses because this guidelines is already available in the SWAYAM platform. You can develop your MOOC courses and you can contact with the concerned authority how to develop the MOOC courses. If you follow those guidelines, then definitely your courses will be included. And it is the need of the hour now to develop these courses because NPTEL is giving this opportunity. Even if you want to translate the existing courses available in the MOOCs, suppose whatever the courses I have shown, if you want to translate this, you can also translate. They will definitely, they will give you this facility, and the guideline of translation is also available. Those who are interested, you can submit your proposals. The proposal date was already accepted by NPTEL till 15th May, and you kindly check the website of National Program for Technological Enhanced Learning whether they have extended this date or not. And similarly, you can develop your MOOC courses, and basically the students will be benefited from this approach. So I think it's enough for you, sir. Thank you, sir. Thank you. Nice to see you actually here. And now next, I would like to move to Dipali Das. Madam, please unmute yourself. I have given you the access. Just you unmute yourself. I have seen Amar Jyoti Bhaskar, sir. Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. Sir, please unmute yourself. Yes, sir. Audible.
Homia Vahat, mane kiman man e journals by e-book ami paam, digital library, national digital library.
Homia Vahat, I think Dr. Nobo Rijit Das, sir, will give the answer of this question. Nobo, sir.
নেশ্যনেল ডিজিটেল লাইব্ৰেৰীত বহু ধৰণৰ ৰিচোৰ্চ আছে, তাৰে ভিতৰত অসমীয়াও আছে। আৰু যদি আপোনাক অসমীয়াখিনি লাগে, এটা ভেৰি বিগিনিং টপ চাৰ্চ বাৰতে আপোনাৰ লেংগুৱেজ বুলি এটা বাৰ আছে, লেংগুৱেজ বুলি এটা অপচন আছে। লেংগুৱেজত গৈ যদি আপুনি অসমীয়াটো মাৰে নহয়, তাতে ড্ৰপ ডাউনত অসমীয়াও আহিব। অসমীয়াটো ক্লিক কৰি দিলে আপোনাৰ অসমীয়া ৰিচোৰ্চ খিনি আহিব। আদাৰৱাইজ আপুনি ব্ৰাউজ বাই ছাবজেক্ট অৰ ইন দ্য চাৰ্চ অপচনত আপুনি যাব পাৰে। লেফ্ট চাইডত থাকিব আপোনাৰ, যেতিয়া চাইডটো খুলিব লেফ্ট চাইডত থাকিব, সেই লেফ্ট চাইডৰ আপুনি চাৰ্চত গৈ পেলাই পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ অসমীয়াৰ যিখন যি অথৰৰ লাগে, ধৰক মহেশ্বৰ নেওগৰ কিবা কিতাপ লাগে আপোনাক, তেতিয়া মহেশ্বৰ নেওগ যদি মাৰি দিয়ে নহয় অথৰ হিচাপে, তেতিয়া মহেশ্বৰ নেওগৰ যিখিনি কিতাপ নেশ্যনেল ডিজিটেল লাইব্ৰেৰী অফ ইণ্ডিয়াত আছে গোটেইখিনি আপোনাৰ ডিছপ্লে হ'ব, আৰু সেইখিনি আপুনি যিখিনি যি দৰকাৰ হয় সেইখিনি আপুনি ডাউনলোড কৰি ল'বও পাৰে। ঠিক তেনেকে বেলেগ অথৰ, ধৰক মামণি ৰয়চম গোস্বামীৰ কিবা লাগে, তেনেকে আপুনি অথৰ হিচাপত চাৰ্চ কৰি ল'ব পাৰে। বা অসমীয়াৰ যদি পাৰ্টিকুলাৰ টাইটেল হিচাপে লাগে, কিন্তু টাইটেল হিচাপত এতিয়া এটা নেশ্যনেল ডিজিটেল লাইব্ৰেৰীত এটা প্ৰব্লেম হৈ আছে, সেইটো সম্পৰ্কত মই অকণমান লিখা মেলা কৰি আছো তেওঁলোকৰ লগত যোগাযোগ। সেইটো হৈছে কি, অকণমান ট্ৰেন্সলিটাৰেশ্যনৰ প্ৰব্লেম, কাৰণ আমি চাৰ্চটো কৰিব লাগে ইংৰাজীৰে, তাৰমানে লেটাৰ্ছ হ'ব ইংৰাজী, লেংগুৱেজ হ'ব অসমীয়া, গতিকে সেইটো লৈ তাৰমানে ট্ৰেন্সলিটাৰেশ্যনত কেতিয়াবা অকণমান দিগদাৰ হয়। সেইকাৰণে আপুনি বস্তুখিনি ফাইণ্ড আউট কৰোঁতে দুবাৰ তিনিবাৰ বিচাৰিব লগা হ'ব পাৰে একেটা বস্তুকে, কাৰণ প্ৰথমবাৰ বিচাৰোঁতে হয়তো আপোনাক নাই বুলি কৈ দিব পাৰে। তেতিয়া আপুনি অকণমান স্পেলিংখিনি ইংৰাজীত লিখা হয়তো, যেনেকে কমল, কমল নামটো মই কে এ এম এ এল লিখিম, এতিয়া কে এ এম এ লিখিলে কমলো বুজাব কামালো বুজাব আমাৰ, গতিকে হুৱেডাৰ উই আৰ চাৰ্চিং ফৰ কমল অৰ কামাল, চ' সেইটো লৈ কেতিয়াবা অলপ ট্ৰেন্সলিটাৰেশ্যনৰ প্ৰব্লেম এটা হয়। ছেম মহেশ্বৰ নেওগ ছাৰৰ কিতাপতে মই এন ডি এল আইত অকণমান প্ৰব্লেম পাইছো, কাৰণ তেওঁলোকৰ এইটো এটা বহুত টেকনিকেল কথা, বহুত ভিতৰৰ ফালে লুকাই আছে, চবখিনি ক'ব নোৱাৰি। তাৰমানে কি, ধৰক এই বস্তুখিনি তেওঁলোকে কেটেলগবিলাক হাৰ্ভেষ্ট কৰিছে বেলেগ বেলেগ ইনষ্টিটিউচনৰ পৰা, গতিকে এই হাৰ্ভেষ্টিং কৰোতে সেই ইনষ্টিটিউচন বিলাকে কি ধৰণে ডাটা এণ্ট্ৰি বিলাক কৰিছিলে সেইটোৰ ওপৰত ডিপেণ্ড কৰে।
কাৰণে
অকণমান চাৰ্চিঙত স্পেলিঙৰ অকণমান কথা আহে, কাৰণ আমি ডাইৰেক্টলি অসমীয়া স্পেলিঙত এতিয়াও চাৰ্চ কৰিব পৰা হোৱা নাই, গতিকে সেইটো কাৰণে অকণমান কেতিয়াবা অসুবিধা হয়। কিন্তু আপুনি বিচাৰি পাব, যথেষ্ট কিতাপ আছে এন ডি এল আই অসমীয়া।
Okay, our honorable principal sir, Dr. Bhajendra Saikia sir, want to say something. Sir, please.
And actually, I want to thank you, Mr. Pal and Navajit Das. It's a very good session. And I think all the participants will be highly they will be fruitful, because all these facilities we need is under this Enlist and e-library. So we have to just explore, we have to spend some time with this e-books and e-library and net. Enlist is actually for a long time we have, but very few people actually explore this Enlist journals in colleges. But facility we have for a long time. Actually, during 2009, there was a problem in the institutions regarding the space of the e-books, books and journals. So government suggested to start it for e-books and e-journals. So from the very beginning, 2009 or 10, all these books are here, but very few people actually explore the facilities of Enlist and e-books and e-journals in our libraries. So I request all the participants, all the faculties to use these facilities. All these actually facilities are granted by government. They spend crores of rupees, but it is still, I think, useless. Very few use these resources. So from this time, I expect that some people will come forward to use our e-library and e-resources. So I want to thank you, both the resource persons, Dr. Navajit Das and Dr. Birendra Pal. So people like you, and also Prashant Dadaka, people like you, you can start a new revolution of e-books in the libraries of Assam College. Okay. Thank you, sir.
Your words are really much valuable for us, because we are also want to bring a movement, and we cannot bring alone. It will be helpful when the entire community will be involved, sir. So it's our objective that we will not go alone, but we will go together. So this is the motto of ACLA now. And
we are actually proud of you, all of you. Actually, we should be proud of you. You started a new revolution.
Thank you, sir. It's a great honor, sir. Thank you, sir. So just we are coming to the end of this program that is called the Vote of Thanks. And before going to Vote of Thanks, some of the participants are requesting for providing this video. We will provide this video in the YouTube channel. We have an official YouTube channel of ICT Cell, Assam College Librarians Association. You go to YouTube and you search ICT Cell ACLA, then you will found this channel, and you will upload all these educational programs, whatever we have conducted in the different colleges, we will upload there. You can get access of this directly from our website. And also we will make available to these videos to the colleges also. To Rangia College, we will make this video available very soon. And also, I would like to also share one thing, that we have a ICT channel, YouTube channel, where we are uploading different educational videos. We have made a videos in Enlist. It will in Assamese language we have made it this time. We have also made videos on Google Classroom, how to use your Google Classroom. You can use your for academic purpose. It is a 20 minutes video, step by step presentation you will get there. Also, there is a presentation on Zoom application, how to use your Zoom applications. Also, there is a videos on the open access e-resources or online e-resources. Whatever the resources we have shown, there is a video already. You can go and you can see it. Also, there is a video. Suppose you are from science stream and you cannot go for lab practical. So there is also a video we have made for it. Till class 12 level, there is a virtual laboratory, virtual lab that is called by MHRD. You can also go and perform your experiment directly in the virtual lab. So it is also possible. Just you go to these videos, whatever we have made, and different n numbers of videos are available in our channel. I request everybody to kindly go at least to see at least once. So now I'd like to conclude, and I'd like to give my special heartiest thanks to the Honorable Principal of Rangia College, Dr. Brajendra Saikia sir, without whose cooperation, without whose initiatives, we cannot come to this platform at Rangia College. And Rangia College is a platform, already Dekha sir has told that this platform is very much important. It seems it's our own college, and we are very much proud that we are today at your own domain, sir. Thank you very much, and your kind support, your kind words are really very much helpful, and it will not only be for today but for our future also. It will be helpful for us, and we were expecting more cooperations, more programs in future also. This is the starting, and we are going to make much programs in futures. Next, I'd like to thank the Honorable General Secretary of Assam College Librarians Association, Dr. Prasant Kumar Deka, sir. Deka, sir, I have told he is the person. Now he is sitting here, but now he is thinking what we have to do next now. So Deka, sir, is that kind of person. Yesterday night also we have worked till 4 o'clock, and he was talking to me that how we have to do, how to conduct in Rangia College, because this is also one of the prestigious college and we have to make them very much proud. So I am really very much proud, Deka, sir, that I am also working under you, under your guidance. We are really doing very well. And definitely your cooperation, your ideas will definitely help us to move ACLA in a further height. Thank you, Deka, sir. Next, I'd like to thank the Honorable Resource Person, Dr. Navajit Das, sir. He is the member of ICT cell of Assam College Librarians Association. He is also the librarian of Hendrick Girls College. And Dr. Navajit Das, sir, has tried his best to make us understand, because these are the things, we have some critical things, that but he has made the things very easy, very simple way. So on behalf of Assam College Librarians Association, I would like to, sir, thank you very much, sir, for your effort. Thank you, Dambo, sir. Next, I would like to give my special thanks to the librarian of Rangia College, Manjushri Devi Madam, without whose work, without whose support, we cannot come to this platform, because she was the lady who was talking with us last 10 or 15 days before, and she want to conduct this program on the very first day itself. But due to some of our technical formalities, we could not do that. But Madam, really, you have done your great job, and you have done your great perform. Really, we are very much thankful to you that you are the librarian of Rangia College, and we are getting you in this platform, Madam. Thank you very much. Now, I would like to thank to the entire academic fraternity of Rangia College, without whose cooperation this program would not have been successful. So I would like to thank each and everyone who belongs or who are related to Rangia College, so that we in future also we will get this kind of cooperation. I would like to thank to all the participants who have very much patiently cooperated and participated in this program, and I'd like to thank everyone. And at the last, I would like to share one information, that a feedback form will be shared with you in the WhatsApp group. Just kindly give your feedback form, which is very much available for us. With this, I would like to thank each and everyone who are here in this platform. Thank you very much, and declare this session as end. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.